Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Honigberg. I'm a cardiologist at the Massachusetts General Hospital in Boston, Massachusetts. And in this video, I'll be talking about long-term cardiovascular disease risk in women with adverse pregnancy outcomes. The key takeaways of this video are to review the links between adverse pregnancy outcomes and cardiovascular disease in women, to describe the mechanisms linking adverse pregnancy outcomes to cardiovascular disease, and to incorporate pregnancy history into preventive cardiovascular care for women in midlife. Adverse pregnancy outcomes are a constellation of conditions that can negatively affect a woman's pregnancy and are associated with worse maternal and fetal outcomes. Gestational diabetes refers to any degree of blood glucose elevation during pregnancy. Gestational hypertension refers to new onset hypertension after week 20 of gestation without accompanying proteinuria or other evidence of end organ dysfunction. Preeclampsia refers to new onset hypertension, again after the 20th week of pregnancy, accompanied by proteinuria or other evidence of end organ dysfunction, such as abnormal liver function tests, abnormal blood counts, or neurologic symptoms, among others. Preterm delivery refers to delivery before 37 weeks of gestation, irrespective of the cause. And finally, small for gestational age refers to a birth weight below the 10th percentile for a given gestational age. Note that this is not a comprehensive list. Other adverse pregnancy outcomes include placental abruption, miscarriage, and stillbirth. These are beyond the scope of this video today. Adverse pregnancy outcomes are associated with the early development of chronic hypertension in affected women. I've displayed here data from the new mom-to-be study recently published, which studied women with and without adverse pregnancy outcomes. And just an average of 5 years after delivery, women with any adverse pregnancy outcome had higher blood pressure and higher rates of chronic hypertension compared to women with unaffected normal pregnancies. This was most prominent for the hypertensive disorders of pregnancy, but was true of other adverse pregnancy outcomes as well. Prevalence of chronic hypertension has been shown to be markedly elevated in women with prior hypertensive disorders of pregnancy in particular in other studies as well. These are data from the UK Biobank, with age shown on the horizontal axis and prevalence of chronic hypertension shown on the vertical axis. Women without a history of hypertension in pregnancy are shown in blue. Women with hypertension in pregnancy are shown in red. And you can see across the range of age and midlife, prevalence of chronic hypertension is much higher in women with prior hypertension during pregnancy. Risk profiles appear different in other respects as well in women with prior hypertension in pregnancy. By 10 years postpartum, affected women have higher blood pressure, lower HDL cholesterol, higher triglycerides, higher body mass index, higher hemoglobin A1C, and a higher prevalence of diagnosed hypertension or metabolic syndrome compared to unaffected women. This translates into increased risk for overt clinical cardiovascular disease later in life. These are data from the Women's Health Initiative that looked at an array of adverse pregnancy outcomes and the risk of atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease. And you can see that for gestational diabetes, low birth weight, preterm delivery, and the hypertensive disorders of pregnancy, there was an excess risk of atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease in women with each of these conditions after adjustment for other conventional cardiovascular disease risk factors. Returning to data from the UK Biobank, we recently observed a syndrome of pan-accelerated cardiovascular aging in women with hypertensive disorders of pregnancy, including a roughly twofold risk of both coronary artery disease and heart failure. Risk of coronary artery disease in women with prior hypertension in pregnancy are even further increased if they deliver very early, before 34 weeks, if they also have a small for gestational age infant, or if they have preeclampsia with severe features. In addition, we observed evidence of accelerated valvular heart disease in women with hypertensive disorders of pregnancy, including both aortic stenosis and mitral regurgitation. Of note, between half and two-thirds of this excess risk of cardiovascular disease appears to be explained by the interval development of chronic hypertension, implying that this may be a key target for preventive efforts. These findings may be due partially to the fact that women with hypertensive disorders of pregnancy have increased genetic risks of both hypertension and obesity compared to unaffected women. I've displayed polygenic risk or genetic risk of systolic blood pressure, diastolic blood pressure and body mass index on the horizontal axis, and the risk of hypertension in pregnancy on the vertical axis. And you can see that across the spectrum of blood pressure as well as body mass index, increased genetic risk is associated with increased risk of a hypertensive disorder of pregnancy. So what are the potential mechanisms linking adverse pregnancy outcomes to clinical cardiovascular disease later in life? One is accelerated development of conventional cardiovascular disease risk factors, chiefly chronic hypertension, as we just reviewed, potentially through shared genetic risks. Other possibilities include persistent endothelial dysfunction, impaired nitric oxide signaling, increased oxidative stress, and heightened systemic inflammation. Overall, we're still in the early days of understanding the biology that links adverse pregnancy outcomes to clinical cardiovascular disease. In the meantime, what are the implications for preventive care of women? Currently, society guidelines advise frequent monitoring of cardiovascular disease risk factors within the first year postpartum and ensuring transition from obstetrical care to longitudinal primary care. In addition, for women who are between the ages of 40 and 75, a history of adverse pregnancy outcomes is considered a risk-enhancing factor for atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease for women who have intermediate calculated risk of a cardiovascular disease event over the next 10 years. So this factors most closely into decisions around prescribing primary prevention statin therapy, where if women have this intermediate calculated risk, the presence of one or more of these risk-enhancing factors should push clinicians to at least have a discussion with, if not recommend, statin therapy for primary prevention. In addition, for women who fall into this intermediate risk zone, coronary calcium scores may be particularly helpful in refining cardiovascular disease risk assessments in women with a prior history of adverse pregnancy outcomes. So to summarize, today we reviewed the links between adverse pregnancy outcomes and cardiovascular disease, described what we do and don't know about the mechanisms linking adverse pregnancy outcomes to cardiovascular risk, and finally, we reviewed how to incorporate pregnancy history into preventive cardiovascular care for women in midlife. Thank you for watching today. I hope you found this video educational.